Hello guys, welcome to course on Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC Development. We are from Digitronics Nepal. We are in actually 8th section. First, which is Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC Architecture. So in this section, we have 4 lecture series, including overview sessions, architecture details, development tools, design methodology, processing system configuration methodology, and basic IP overview of Zynq Ultrascale Plus. So let's begin with our lecture first. Actually, Zynq Ultrascale Plus is 16 nanometer FinFET technology based embedded application based FPGA family. So it is also called as multi-processing system on chip. So it have different processing element and FPGA fabric inside of that single system on chip. So this Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC have followed the main architecture of Zynq 7000. So it have 2 major sections. One is processing system, another is programmable logic, as in the Zynq 7000. So in processing system, there is application processing unit, that is ARM Cortex A53 processor. So that is programmable processor from ARM. And another is real-time processing unit, that is RPU, which is actually the dual core ARM Cortex R5 processor. And there is graphics processing unit, that is ARM Mali 400 base graphics processing unit. So these 3 are major processing unit. One is APU, RPU, and GPU. So number of processor in that APU section might vary according to the type of device, so which we are going to talk on the next presentation. And another thing is platform management unit inside that processing system, and CSU, that is configuration security unit. So aside of this processing system components, there is another section called programmable logic. So that programmable logic consists of high speed FPGA fabric. So it have 100G Ethernet MAC, PCI Express, integrated block for Intel Econ, configurable logical block, so that is usual logic blocks, signal processing blocks, and programmable IO, along with video encoding and decoding blocks. So major features can be categorized according to this chart. So there are 3 major variants in Ultrascale Plus MPSoC family. So one is CG device. Actually, the CG device consists of dual core ARM processor and dual core real time processor, that is dual core APU and dual core RPU. And CG is actually for general purpose Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC, and EG is also for general purpose but enhanced. And another is EV, that is video processing based family of Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC. So CG device have dual core ARM, and EG device have quad core, and EV also have quad core ARM A53. So I'm talking about RPU. There is dual core RPU on CG and dual core RPU on EG and dual core RPU on EV device. However, there is no Mali graphics inside that CG device, and there is Mali graphics within that EG and EV device. So number of peripherals and number of programmable cells or programmable logic have little variations, and application are also a little bit different. So we can see here each device are mostly good for sensor processing, motor control, traffic engineering, etc. And EG and EV device are mostly good for video processing, machine vision, computer vision, and some defense applications. So the architecture of Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC is also a little bit different according to that CG, EV, and EG devices. So we are currently seeing the architecture of siege device. So we can see here siege device have dual core ARM, dual core RPU, memory unit, platform management unit, configuration security unit, system function, that is DMA and other WDT, and there is some high speed connectivity including PCI 1.0 or 2.0 and some PSGTR gigabit transceivers, and in general connectivity there are some general protocol based bus protocols as UART, SPI, CAN, etc. And on this LO section, that is actually the programmable logic, and other sections are processing system. So inside that programmable logic we have storage and signal processing block, general purpose IO, and high speed connectivity. So these three sections are available in programmable logic fabric, that is FPGA fabric, and all the other things are available in our processing system elements. So we have PCI Gen 4 inside this programmable logic. So we are talking about this CG block diagram. So that is for general purpose application based Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC device. So another is easy device. So easy device just have the Mali, ARM Mali 400 graphic processing unit. So that graphic processing unit consists of geometry processor and pixel processor, and all the other things are quite similar, but this easy device have a bit more number of APU, that is ARM processing unit A53. There are four APUs, application processing unit, and there are two ARM Cortex R5 based real-time processing unit, and some extra high-speed connectivity bus protocols like GTS, GTY, and Interlaken, including 100G EMAC. So each device are mostly good for high-speed processing, defense electronics, and computer vision application, while the CG device are good for some embedded applications like motor control and some traffic engineering application. So, and the tough one, that is the intense capability based FPGA Ultrascale Plus MPSoC is EB device, that is video processing based enhanced Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC. So this block have 4 APU as the easy device, RTU or RPU is the easy device, and it have the graphic processing unit, and it have some extra things, that is video codec. So this video codec is not available in the previous easy device, so this is the extra thing, so it can process furthermore high speed video inputs and provides the real time video outputs. So these are the major things, and I'm talking about this APU. Actually APU are good for application, such type of application which are going to need some basic processing, so some like creating some bootable applications. And this RPU or real-time processing unit is actually good for security based application, so it can provide some security enhancement on the implementation of any logic on FPGA. So graphic processing unit is good for, or graphic processing unit is utilized for processing of graphics, videos, etc. So if we get video from video codec, then we can send it to the memory in and into the graphic processing unit, then we can again transfer these things into memory and output device. So this is the main basic flow for GPU based applications. So we can differentiate each application for a specific units, that is we can utilize sometime application processing unit, graphic processing unit, and some high speed application of programmable logic. And there are other lots of things which we are going to discuss, like we have some system functions, configuration units, and platform management units. So there are different things which we are going to talk on later session. So while we go to the IP catalog, there is IP of Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC. So that IP also shows the basic overview of our Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC and different units. So this is the very basic mode which we are going to also going to see on the IP catalog of Vivado 2017.4. And this is the advanced mode. So advanced mode actually show up all the sub blocks, that is we can see some sub functional block inside the top block, that is inside RPU, inside APU and graphic processing unit. We can see the sections, so we can also see the bus connectivity and some interface, like intricate interfaces which connect different type of blocks like AXI interconnect. And we'll talk about this A53 ARM Cortex processing unit. So this processing unit are available in dual core or quad core format in Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC. So while talking about JCU102, that is Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC development board, that is easy device board which have 4 APU, 2 RPU and the Mali graphics. And that easy device doesn't have the video codec section in the PL part, so that easy device are good for computer vision application and some embedded processing application, enhanced embedded processing application that are categorized as general application while selecting the product. So that is called easy device. So this APU actually run on 1.5 GHz frequency and it have ARMv8 A architecture support, and it have independent memory management unit and some different cache structures for processing, and it also allow us to design with crypto API support. And the detail of A53 are been shown here. Actually this is from Acronix machine, so this architecture are actually designed by Acronix machine based on UK. So this ARM Cortex A53 has been licensed by ARM to Zynq. So Zynq utilize that core, soft core inside the Zynq Ultrascale Plus MPSoC devices. So another thing is R5 ARM Cortex, so that is actually good for circuit based application. So this is good for real time processing also. So while we need to process the real time data, real time inputs and keep the real time outputs, then that are good for real time processing unit. So that APU which we have just discussed previously is good for like booting some application, Linux application and some embedded application which commands the programmable logic and sends the instruction to those programmable logic. So that time APU is good for those application, and RPU is good for some embedded processing and real time processing. So along with some security enablement. So RPU is good for security based application also. So it have better floating point unit and memory protection unit. So these two sections actually allow us to process some better floating point based operations, and it also provides some memory security and protection applications. So another thing is ARM Mali 400 based GPU, that is graphic processing unit. And inside that graphic processing unit, there is geometry processor and 2 pixel processor. 1 geometry processor is there, that is called GP, and 2 pixel processor are there. So these things actually allow us to process intense graphic data, so like videos and images. So it utilizes OpenGL ES1.1 based software support. So that open graphic processing unit or open graphic language is utilized for this 400 base GPU from ARM. So other features of GPU are being shown here. So actually this GPU is operating at 667 megahertz and it have some 4K texture input and 4K render output resolutions, and it can also provide us 2D and 3D graphic acceleration. So we can see the GPU clock, and inside that there is geometric processor. That geometric processor is utilized for some processing of graphics along with their geometrical orientation. And another is pixel processor, which is good for pixel processing of any image or video. So we can also have that OpenGL interface, that is OpenGL ES application interface, for programming this GPU. And we can also program this GPU from traditional Vivaru SDK. Yes, we are going to program those APU and RPU. We can also program GPU from similar tool basically. And there is a high speed IO unit, and there are also programmable logic, which are shown in the yellow part, which we have talked a little bit in the previous section. That programmable logic are active in Ultrascale PLUS in a little bit different manner than the 7000 and Ultrascale blocks. So there are some high speed transceivers inside. After that, there is CLB DSP and block RAM. There are some clocking memory, and there is again CLB DSP and clock RAM. So this is the basic architecture of how devices, different segments are planned in Ultrascale PLUS MPSoC. So there are high speed PSPL interfaces like EXI interfaces, and we have different bus protocol interfaces for interconnecting there. And we can have isolation type of design flow, so we can isolate our programmable logic design and processing system design. So we can have different type of processing system based design for that single type of programmable logic, which we are going to talk on the second section. And the 16 nanometer FinFET architecture of Zynq Ultrascale PLUS MPSoC actually allows to enhance the power utilization, so we can reduce the overall power utilization. So that 16 nanometer FinFET architecture, that is the high density silicon architecture, provides us less power consumption, that is watt consumption per area or per operation. So we can accelerate our applications on programmable logic. So there are different acceleration methodology for enhancing our operation. So we can implement some basic operation, basic algorithm in programmable logic, or we can design some accelerator there using SLS or SDSoC, etc. So there is built codec unit inside that EB device. So this is used for some high speed encoding and decoding of video data. And another high speed interface is PCI. There we have PCI Gen2